Hello, 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 hello. Today is March 2nd, 2022. At least for me. Maybe no more for you. Solutions of problem 137. A moving plane electromagnetic wave. Definitely not a high school problem. Without any question, a JEE advanced problem, and probably also a JEE main problem. We were given the E field in this form. I discussed this in great detail, in all details, in my lecture 27 of 802. This is the E field that is given. It's a vector. And the vector is in the Z direction. The magnitude of E is 2. This is the unit vector in the Z direction. So the magnitude of E, which is called E0, is 2. And it is in the Z direction. Now, we normally rewrite these things by introducing a frequency omega, which is 2 pi divided by the period of the oscillation, and by a vector k, which is 2 pi divided by lambda. K is not a vector. By the magnitude k, k is 2 pi divided by lambda. Now, once you do that, once you write it in this form, k is 2 pi divided by lambda, since lambda is v times capital T, obviously, if it moves with a speed v, and it does that for a time period capital T, which is the period of the oscillation, it has moved over a distance lambda. That is the definition of lambda. So this is obvious. T is 2 pi divided by omega, then V is omega divided by K. And that's why this is such a nice form. Because you can then immediately tell what the speed is of the electromagnetic wave. Omega divided by K. Now, because there is a plus sign here, the wave must be moving in the minus y direction. If there had been a minus sign here, then the wave would be moving in the plus y direction. If you have problems with that, plot the E vector, the magnitude, versus y for t equals 0. That's trivial because this goes away. Then you increase the small t by 1 over t capital, a tenth of a period, and you plot it again. And you will have seen, in this case, that the whole wave has moved in the minus y direction. The pointing vector is the direction in which the entire electromagnetic wave moves. That must then be in the E minus B direction. Of course, I cover that again in my lecture 27, but I cover the pointing vector also probably in other lectures of 802. So if we now make an XYZ diagram, X plus X plus Y, and perpendicular to the paper, plus Z. This is the positive side, this is the positive side, and this is the positive side, and here is zero. Notice I always choose a right-handed coordinate system, because if you don't do that, you really set yourself up for problems. A right-handed coordinate system is that X crossed Y is in the direction of plus Z. If you take X and you cross it as vectors, X times Y, it's in the direction plus Z. And that's the coordinate system that I have chosen. So we know that E is in the Z direction. We know that E cross B must be in the minus Y direction. We concluded that. Therefore, B must be in the minus X direction. It must be in the minus X direction because E cross B is in the minus Y direction. So we have solved that part. B must be in the minus X direction. It follows from Maxwell's equations that E0 divided by B0 is C divided by N, when N is the index of refraction. C is the speed of light in vacuum, if we assume that this is done in vacuum, or even in air, C would still be very close. Speed of light would still be very close to C. The index of refraction I gave you is 1.5. In other words, B0 can now easily be calculated because you know the ratio that E0 over B0 is this, and so B0 is then 10 to the minus 8 Tesla. That's the magnitude. If you want to write B0 in terms of a vector, that is fine. Just have we written E in terms of a vector here, then B0 is minus 10 to the minus 8 in the direction X roof. The minus sign, we just discussed that it is mandatory for B to be in the minus X direction, otherwise E cross B would not be in the minus Y direction. So now we have done this. Now, I argued earlier that omega over k equals phi. And omega over k is c over n. Because phi is c over n. But we also know what omega is. And we know what k is. This is k. In other words, c over n, which is omega over k, here you see omega, 4 pi times 10 to the 15th, and then you see k here. K is 2 pi divided by lambda. And so out pops that lambda is 10 to the minus 7 meters, a tenth of a micron. Well, it may be too much math for you, but always remember that mass is the language of physics. Mass stands on its own. The history of mass is not the history of physics. Mass stands on its own. Go back to the Greek mass, Pythagoras. No physics. Mass. Physics, however, stands not on its own. Physics needs a language. Math has its own language. Physics needs a language, and that language is math. Never forget that. You cannot do physics without math. But you can do math without physics. You really can. In case that Noor is watching this video, do you know this, Noor? I'm wearing your ring. Wonderful ring. Okay, if you can't do this problem, don't feel bad. As I said, it is really beyond high school, far beyond high school. So we'll be friends anyhow, that is always the case, regardless of whether you can do a problem or not. And don't forget, the most conservative law all of life, not only physics, is that we are friends.